What's up, my meatballs? It's Aaronitmar. Welcome back to Pokémon OmegaRuby Wonderlocke. Last time we got our first Pokémon and did all of that fun opening new game stuff. We talked to our dad and we helped Wally catch his first Pokémon and we received Wonder Trade in exchange for that. So now we can officially trade away some of our Pokémon. We've got three Pokémon that we caught last time that we are going to be able to trade away and get our brand new party members for. So let's go ahead and do that. If you guys could drop a like on this video, that would be awesome, and I would really appreciate it. So let's go ahead and save the game real quick, and we're going to hop on to Wonder Trade. I went ahead and did all of the connection stuff to begin with for the first time off screen, so we don't have to worry about going through like the tutorials and stuff. And we can start this episode straight away by just trading away our Pokemon. So, alright, connecting. Why is it taking so long to connect? Successfully connected. There we go. Alright. So let's go ahead and do that. And hit up Wonder Trade. And of course, we're going to have to save the game again because that's going to be rather a pain. Alright, we've got three Pokemon we can trade now. So let's go ahead and do a Wonder Trade. We've got our first party member, Hungry, the Wurmple that we caught on our very first route. Yes, let's trade that Pokemon. Alright, so hopefully we get some good... Oh, he's got a Petalburg. I probably should have taken that from him, but I guess it's not a big deal. Hopefully we can get something good, because otherwise I would be pretty sad. Just as a reminder of the rules, if I get a duplicate Pokemon, it's sort of the modified Dupes Clause for the Wonderlocke, I do have the opportunity to trade them away. So if I've gotten a Pokemon before, I can actually trade them away. Alright, so we're trading with Jesse from California. So let's go ahead and it's waiting a moment. So if I get like I've got a Wurmple, a Poochyena, and a Zigzagoon, and if I get any of those in the Wonder Trade, ooh, we get, what is his Pokemon name? Not Squirtle. It's not Squirtle. What Pokemon is it? It's a good Pokemon, I know that. A Clauncher, alright. Unfortunately, we don't get to nickname this one. It doesn't receive a nickname. Take good care of Clauncher. I will do just that. So there we go. So now, basically, if we get another Clauncher, I have the ability, or have the opportunity, to trade it back and get a new Pokemon. So that's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and do another trade real quick. I did not mean to hit no. I meant to hit yes, so there we go. So we save the game, and let's go ahead and Wonder Trade again. I hate that we have to do all of this startup stuff again. But there we go. Alright, so let's check out... Wow, that's a pretty good Clauncher. Swords Dance, Crab Hammer, Bubble Beam, and Flail. Awesome. Alright, so let's go ahead and trade away. Wait. Yes. I keep hitting B on accident. Alright, so let's go ahead and trade away our Poochyena. Our good friend Poochyena. Alright, so let's hopefully get a trade partner a bit faster this time. That would be awesome. But yeah, that Clauncher's really, it's probably going to be a very good asset to the team. Because it looks like it was bred competitively. Or at least for competitive battle, and it was just sort of a person's scraps. Which means that's going to have decent IVs, a good nature, on top of having a really good moveset. Alright, we got a Japanese player this time. I'm not sure, someone in the comments could refresh my memory. I'm not sure if the X and Y Wonder Trade sort of balances, not balances, but reaches over into the X and Y Wonder Trade. Alright, I'm a chop. Awesome. I'm not sure if it does... I'm not sure if I can trade with an X and Y cartridge, to my Omega Ruby cartridge. I'm not sure. It seems like we can, because we got Clauncher, so unless they traded it over specifically, we can trade with that. So there we go. We got, our second trade. Let's go ahead and do our final one. We're going to want to, let's see what we got here. Karate Chop, Strength, Revenge, and Seismic Toss. Level 23, which is really overpowered for the moment. So it looks like it was just a randomly caught one. So we've got our Zigzagoon finally to trade away. Bandit the Zigzagoon. I didn't check to see if Poochyena had an item, but I don't think it did, so we don't really have to worry about that too much. So let's go ahead and hurry up. I don't know why this is taking so long. I mean, I guess it is kind of late, but I mean, to take this long to trade with one person is kind of a little bit ridiculous. But I guess it's got to go across two different servers. All right, so nice to meet you, Domino from Alaska. Interesting. So we got a Japanese player and then two Americans, one from California and one from Alaska. Or at least that's where they say they're from anyway. All right, so let's trade away our buddy Zigzagoon, and we're getting an Electrike. All right, so we've got a pretty decently balanced team so far. We got a grass, a water, a fighting, and an electric type. So this is going to be a pretty decent time. I'm pretty disappointed that we can't nickname our Pokemon. That's kind of a shame. But regardless, we can still use them. All right, let me back out, because I like having the map where it was. What do I hit back here? Yeah, I do, and then I... All right, cool. All right, so that's a lot more convenient than on X and Y. But there we go, we have... It took 7 minutes to do that, man. All right, but there we go, we've got our new team all with us. Let's check them out real quick. We got a level 1 Clauncher, which is going to be a little bit difficult to level up at the beginning here. I don't know why I spoke so fast. And then we've got our Machop, which seems to be just, like I said, a random thing. And it's going to suck because we're not going to make this a Machamp, which is kind of annoying. And Electrike, level 13, doesn't seem to be, met level 13. Oh, and Route 110. So I guess, oh yeah, it was caught here. I forgot Electrike was a Gen 3 Pokemon at first. But we got a nice Pokemon early on, so we got a pretty decent party going here. I'm going to restore. I'm used to Switch being immediately down there. I'm going to go ahead, you know what? We can just drag. That's so much easier. I'm going to put Clauncher in the front so we can get some early experience with it. Both Electrike and Machop are much stronger than they need to be, so we don't have to worry about them for a bit. And they will sort of be our wild card Joker backups, I guess. Bum, 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 bum. All right, so let's head to Rustboro as per our dad's suggestion. If you're going to throw a Pokeball, weaken the wild Pokemon first. It'll be easier to catch if it's been poisoned, burned, lulled to sleep, or such like. Wow, that's a big word for a little kid. Wow. All right. Whoa. Fly away. That's what you get. I forgot Pico is going to be here soon. We're going to be able to see 3D Pico. Oh, yeah, you're not a trainer. I always think she's a trainer. I always walk up to her, but she's not. But this guy is. Leaving footprints in the sand is so fun. You bet your biscuit it is. You bet. Alright, so, Youngster Billy. So now is where the game gets interesting. Last episode was sort of just set up for the series. And while it was awesome to see the nostalgia mixed with the, the new sight of new Pokemon stuff. It was sort of, you know, just the standard, Pokemon setup. Now we are going to be able to do some, So we're going to do the do. Alright, so you're going to use Bites. So now you're just going to waste my time, so I'm just going to go ahead and leer you. But now we get to actually set up and do the Wonderlocke, and the challenge actually begins. Which is great because, I don't know, I really enjoyed doing the randomizer Nuzlocke of Heart Gold. It really gave the game a unique spin on, you know, rather than playing the game as a normal playthrough, I was able to do it sort of randomized and give it a challenge run and stuff. I have no idea where C-Dot is at on this bide. So, alright, so he's done. So, oh, now we're gonna have to work through this hardened spam. And of course you're gonna do that. Of course that's happens. Alright, we're good. He doesn't have Protect or anything. So we should be good. I should have just attacked straight away. I just wasted my time doing Leer and stuff. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to doing this this challenge run and giving this game a sort of breath of fresh air that it deserves. Or that is, you know, sort of... You know, for someone who's played all the Pokemon games as many times as I have, it can get a bit tedious to replay the same games over and over again. So this gives us such a nice refresh. I keep saying it, but it gives us like a refreshing twist on the same old games, even if this is a brand new remake. So there we go. Oh, I shouldn't have done that, because Talo is gonna kill. Alright, we're gonna switch to Electrike. We're switching to Electrike, because I don't want to risk losing a Pokemon already. Episode 2, no way. Alright, so let's switch to Electrike, and we will get this going. He has Spark, I noticed it. He's level 13, alright? Alright, so I should be able to control this Pokemon still. See, I knew it was coming. I knew a Flying-type move was coming at any moment. And so I figured, Electric won't obey. Come on. That's one thing we're going to have to worry about. Really? We're going to have to worry about them not obeying me? Alright, so there we go. Talo is down. Down for the count. And Clauncher gains some experience, as well as Treecko will as soon as Clauncher's done leveling up. There we go. Shrimp grew to level 9 and got Quick Attack, which is nice. And this should be it. There we go. Defeat Youngster Billy. Wow, I got sand in my runners. They're all gritty. I really hope runners mean shoes, because undies would be awkward. Alright, is there a... Ah, the sea. I wonder what it's like at the bottom of the sea. I wonder what that's a hint towards. Alright, let's see what you are. Mr. Briny lives in that little college there. Cottage there beside the sea. He lives in the college. He was once an amazing sailor who never feared the sea, however stormy. Oh my gosh, it's Pico! And there's Mr. Briny! Oh, my pretty Pico's as full of energy as usual. That's awesome, man. Alright, is this a... That's not a battle. My Pokemon is staggeringly tired. I should have brought a potion. Can you give me one of your potions? Why not? What's he gonna give us? You better give us something in return. This is gonna be a waste of time. Wow. We got nothing for that. We wasted a potion for nothing. But here we go. Let's pick up some berries. Why not? We gotta pick up these berries, man. Alright. Ooh, that was a pretty animation. Whoa, alright. Are we... I guess I can't press A from the side. Alright, so there we go. Orin berries. Orin berry. Alright. Now, is this going to be a trainer fight? I kept encountering the same kind of Pokemon. Then the Dex Knife got better, and now I can find rare Pokemon easily. Alright. Neat. Alright, so this is a guy that's going to have, like, a Hyper Potion for a level, like, 5 Zigzagoon. Oh, sure, I'll accept your challenge. I have a lot of money. That is arrogant and rude. You don't have to just say, I have a lot of money. It was irrelevant to why I wanted to battle you. You're just a Pokemon trainer. It was completely irrelevant. Yeah, so he's got a Zigzagoon, and if we kill it one hit... It's going to, or if we don't kill it one hit, he's going to heal it with a Hyper Potion, which is just mad overkill. Let's go to Shrimp. I don't want to use the high-level Pokemon too much, half because of the headache of having to worry about, like, the loafing around and it falling asleep and stuff, because that's going to be such a pain to work around. It didn't even occur to me that we're going to have to worry about that. But, let's use Absorb. And we should... Ugh. This is going to be an annoying battle. Alright. Let's keep... Just let's skip the Absorb Span for now. He's going to end up using a Hyper Potion anyway, so we may as well take advantage of this opportunity. Alright. I don't know why we'd be taking advantage of this opportunity at all, but let's just kill this guy. Wow. That did nothing. These are doing nothing. Literally nothing. And I'm gonna have to use Absorb again to heal my HP. We're not getting as much healed as he's doing damage to us. We're getting three. Oh, okay. Okay, man. Alright, I really hope this guy doesn't have the Hyper Potion like he did in the last game. Nope, he does. He's got a full restore. Come on, man. That's even worse. That's overkill, man. Alright, I just went ahead and cut that because that took way too long. But basically, Treecko leveled up to level 10 and Clauncher leveled up to level 6, I think. So let's go ahead and heal up Shrimp real fast. Did I say Shrimpy? I guess I'll just call it Shrimpy for now. Why not? Doesn't make any sense anyway. I have not actually caught a Pokemon on this route yet. So why don't we go ahead and do that? I just realized I hadn't caught a Pokemon. That was the whole point of the Wonderlocke. Alright, a Wurmple. So because we, are Wonder Trading this away, the fact that it's a duplicate doesn't matter because we're just going to trade it away anyway. It's only the traded Pokemon, if it's a duplicate, that... Oh my gosh, I can't say that word. Duplicate. That matters if it's a duplicate or not. So we're going to have to worry about that when the time comes. Alright, so we got Wurmple. Nice. And I'm not going to worry about nicknaming these anymore. Honestly, I don't care that much, because we're just trading them away anyway. And speaking of trading, why don't we go ahead and do that right now, get another trade out of the way. It's hard to look at your screen when you're recording this the way I am. And no, don't disconnect. All right, we're still connected. That's good. Wonder Tray. This will speed up the process. Because I'm looking at my computer screen when I'm recording this, but in order to do the touchscreen controls, I have to look down. All right. So let's go ahead and trade away our Wurmple. And hopefully we get something good. What if we got a Garchomp? A Garchomp or a Rayquaza? Communication failed. What? Why did communication fail? What is happening? Why did it fail? That's not good. That's not good news. Hopefully it's not a problem with my internet, because that would be very unfortunate, I would have to say. Quite unfortunate. Hopefully that was a one-time thing, because I've been using the internet all day and hasn't been a single problem. And I just wonder traded like 15 minutes ago. So please have just been an issue with the person they were trying to pair me with. It's got a bright powder, nice. Alright, so Meng from Minnesota. Nice to meet you, Minnesota. Alright, let's go ahead and trade and see what you're gonna give me. Hopefully it's not garbage. If you give me garbage, you're bad in my book. You are bad in my book. A Zigzagoon. I knew it. I just knew when I saw the trainer sprite what it was gonna be. So, I guess, well, he sent over Zigzags. So I'm not sure. I guess I'll keep it because I haven't technically been traded a Zigzagoon. I've just caught one. So I guess this technically counts as a trade. So now if I get another Zigzagoon, it won't matter. Or it will matter because I didn't mean to do that. I have to go back. There we go. Because I like looking at the map when I'm not on the Wonder Trade. So I guess now we've got a Zigzagoon added to our party. Yeah, I guess that's it. Does it have any item? No, it doesn't. What are its moves? Literally knows like less than a good move. Like, it doesn't even know tackle. What is that about? I guess we'll have to worry about that later. But here we are in Petalburg Woods. We can't catch another Pokemon here, actually. Let's see what's on this side. Hey, buddy. Sometimes there are things on the ground even if you can't see them. That's why I always check where I'm walking. Okay, so I think right here. No? Where is it at? It's one of these. This is the one I stepped on to begin with? Yes, it is. And we got a potion. So at least we got that potion back for wasting for that kid that we healed way back in the, like 10 minutes ago. Alright, what are you doing here? You're no better than a thief if you try to steal someone else's Pokemon. Alright, whatever. Okay, let's get this item. It's a Pokeball. Alright, so we just made it for the one we used to catch the Wurmple for the Zigzags. Alright, let's head back in. And now we can actually head forward in Petalburg Woods. Get through there, all right. It's gonna be a battle here, and I think I'm gonna start cutting out all the battles. Obviously, I'll report if I die, but yeah, let's just fight him. All right, what is this Pokemon gonna be? Should we sneak up on it? Why not? Let's sneak up on it. Like we're a big, like it's a big surprise that we just stepped on a Pokemon that we just saw. But we did step on him, right? Oh no, it's just a wild Psychoth appeared. All right. So this is going to have to be our capture for this time around. Not sure if it was a good idea to use one of the like tail sticking out Pokemon, but we will see. We will see. Two. Nope. Nothing. All right. You're gonna put me to sleep. You know, it'd be really nice to have this kind of Pokemon, because remember back in my Heart Gold Randomizer Nuzlocke, having, what was his name? Swarp the Swalot. It was awesome having him, because he knew Yawn, so he could do the same thing that Slakoth is doing, putting us to sleep. Alright, and we fell asleep. Of course. Of course, of course. Even though I knew that was coming. Alright, let's go shrimp. We're gonna need to do some damage to it. Hopefully it doesn't, like, yawn all of our Pokemon to sleep. Because otherwise, that's gonna be pretty irritating. So I knew that was gonna happen. I don't know why I expected any other, because it probably only knows one move. And it's that move. Let's go Electrike. We're gonna have to keep switching in until we actually can do some damage to this Pokemon. Be able to do damage this turn. Because he's gonna be loafing around for this turn. But unfortunately, there's a chance that Electrike will just disobey us, so... Alright, luckily... Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, that was close. Oh, he actually knows Scratch. Okay. Alright, let's use a Pokeball now. And hopefully we'll catch this thing before he starts putting every party member we have to sleep, because that is where it's going to get very irritating. Very irritating indeed. Alright, there we go. Caught Slakoth, no problem. Now we need to get through this forest. Let's get through it quick. Alright, Clauncher, you're level 8. Good job, Clauncher. I'm proud of you. And Slakoth's added to the Pokedex. Alright. Hooray! Registration completed. Alright, I'm not gonna name this thing. Alright, still on our part. You know what? Let's just go ahead and do it. Right now, let's do it. Online with others. Let's just get out of the way. I'm not sure if I should do it every time I catch a Pokemon. I think that would be best. It might be not the most time efficient, but it keeps us from doing a huge batch at the beginning or end of an episode, and it keeps the episodes more entertaining, I think. So let's go ahead and trade away our Slakoth. Hopefully we don't get something like a Zigzag Goon like we did last time. Come on, that was just garbage. Just total crap. Alright. Come on. This is the worst part of this. I can't just immediately get the Pokemon. I have to wait for a trade partner. And alright, we looks like we got a Tokyo person. Alright, so... let's go ahead and wonder trade this away. Goodbye, Slakoth. Sending to... I'm not even going to pretend to know what that means. It could mean, like, cat soup for all I know. Ooh, a Ralts! Nice! So even though we didn't get... We didn't get a Ralts on the route that we can get a Ralts, and we didn't, like, try it. We still get the, we still get a Ralts. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty neat. And there we go. That is it. We've got a full party, which means, now any Pokemon we catch, any future Pokemon we catch are going to be in the PC, and we're going to have to wait to Wonder Trade those away. But here we go. We've got, not a one to be found. A scientist guy. Hello, have you seen any Pokemon called Shroomish around here? I really love that Pokemon. Me too, buddy. Me too. And we got this guy in red. Who could he be? I don't know, but I do know. I was going to ambush you, but you had to dawdle in Petalburg Woods. Forever, didn't you? I got sick of waiting, so here I am. You, Devin Researcher, hand over those papers. You're a Pokemon trainer, aren't you? You've got to help me, please! Question mark? Huh? What do you think you're doing? What, you're going to protect him? No one who crosses Team Magon gets any mercy, not even a kid. Come on and battle me. Alright, and you're going to do some weird stance for us, but we're going to battle you anyway. With our awesome Clauncher. Alright, so we're challenged by Team Magma Grunt. Listen to this awesome theme. Alright, so he's going to send out Poochyena. And we're going to keep going with our Clauncher. And the cool part about this fight is we are going to receive... Oh, you're asleep. Oh, forget this. Alright, let's risk using Machop, because even if he gets hit, it's not going to be that big of a deal because we're more than double his level. More than double Poochyena's level, I should say. Or, of course, Sand Attack is a thing. But the cool thing about this fight is afterwards, rather than get a dumb Great Ball like before, we get... the experience share, which makes this a much more, makes leveling up a much simpler task. Hopefully you don't, like, ignore us. Oh, come on, quit avoiding the attack. That's so not fair. Sand Attack once, and it's still ruined. Sand Attack should not be a Wow. Wow. This is ridiculous, man. I'm gonna probably have to stick to some low-level... like Pokemon to start with, because this is a problem. Even Electrike won't listen to us, and it's only like we have a Pokemon at almost that level. Wake up. Oh my gosh. Should I just keep going with my starter? Let's just go back to shrimp. Just go back to shrimp. Oh, that's a pain in the butt. Alright. Howl, that's right, you better howl. Alright, you better not howl, I mean, that's not good. Alright, let's go ahead and start absorbing it. That does decent damage, which I'm kind of surprised at considering how much... Ooh. How much, how strong he... Or how... He's only one level weaker than us, so I was expecting it to do a lot less damage, but that's not that bad. He's going to keep using Howl, which is not good, because it's going to give him a raise, and I probably shouldn't have dawdled with all those, those karate chops that missed and then fell asleep and then all this garbage. Alright, so you're going to use Tackle, but this should... Oh, gosh, a critical hit. A critical hit. I'm going to heal. No, absorb, go, absorb, hit, kill it, thank you, alright, so this is the second time that's happened. At least I'm having my wits about me and noticing that, like, it would have killed. I was thinking about doing Quick Attack, which I knew wouldn't have killed, and I was very worried that was going to happen, but Shrimp grew to level 11, and we won that fight. Oh, I gotta tell you, these Nuzlocke, Wonderlocke runs, they keep you on your toes, man. These Nuzlocke variants, they keep you on your toes when you're playing, so that's good. Grr, you've got some nerve meddling with Team Magma. Come on and battle me again! I wish I could say that, but I'm out of Pokemon. And hey, we have Team Magma also after something in Rustboro. I'll let you go for today. And then he waddles away. Ooh, that was awfully close. Thanks to you, he didn't rob me of these important papers. I know, I'll give you this as my thanks. And he gives us the experience share, which we can now finally turn on. Alright, super high-tech device. I just train every fiber of my brain and body to develop. Alright, so basically we can all get experience at once, obviously. And he's going to heal our Pokemon. Thank you very much. You had your Pokemon HP restored. Ah, I did not see Magma Thug say they were after something in Rustboro 2. Uh-oh, it's a crisis. I can't be wasting time. And he actually runs away this time. Alright, so... How do I turn the experience share on? I forget. It's an item, right? I thought it was like a thing. Alright, so we gotta turn it. Alright, so it's on by default. Alright, so there we go. So we've got one more route we can catch Pokemon on. And then we, Oh, I thought you were facing the wrong way. I couldn't tell what you were. But obviously he was a bug catcher. Obviously. Alright, so we've got, I think, one more route we can catch Pokemon on. Maybe two. Before we get to Rustboro. I'm not sure how they split up the routes in the next section. But we need to hurry this up. Alright, he's only got one Pokemon, which is good. And I think it is weak to water, so let's go ahead and use Crab Hammer, and hopefully it will take it out in one hit shot either way. There we go, Ninkata, you're down, buddy. You're down, buddy. Alright, so level 9, Clauncher, excellent. This thing is going to be such a good, useful team member. Alright, let's see what Vice Grip does. The target is gripped and it squeezed from both sides to inflict damage. 55 power, as opposed to Flail, which less HP, Bubble Beam... Everything is stronger than it. No, we're not going to know Vice Grip. Not now. Should we be deleted and replace the Vice Grip? Keep all moves. I got to keep remembering, these are like competitively bred. So they've got moves I wouldn't ordinarily have. So the moves they have are going to be crap. Go to level 2. Wait, what is this? Oh, this is routes. Gotcha. All right, see, that's going to be an issue if we get foreign Pokemon. I'm not going to know what's what. So luckily when they evolve, they turn into their English names in this. So that will be good for us. Yeah, that would be good for us. But this isn't good for us, running into freaking wild Pokemon. Hey, there's a Shroomish. Can we call that guy back? He wanted to know about a Shroomish. Can we call it back? No, we can't. Alright, so let's just go ahead and run. I like keeping these in, for the Nuzlocke battles. Or at least I like keeping... Alright. I like not doing repels because I might catch shiny. You never know. Wait, who are you? This is the Petalburg recon team checking in. I'm afraid I have to begin an apology, Miss Courtney. It's not good news. The mission is a no-go. A little something cropped up and got in the way. Roger that. Got it. Will do. I'll continue investigating that energy we detected. What are you? Who are you? What are you? ... Phew. This is a new cutscene. But that kid sure had some promise as a trainer, I'd say. Alright. I don't know what this is, but that was cool. A brand new cutscene for us to explore. Alright, let's back out, go back to the map, and tap it, and zoom in. I gotta get used to these controls still. Alright, this is all considered one route, actually. So I do not have a separate, encounter here. Petalburg Words is its own, its own area, but, I'm sorry, I'm so scatterbrained, it's kinda late. But Route 104 connects all the way down here, so I don't get an extra capture here. So nothing until Rustboro City, so I can pretty much just ignore battles. It's got all these berries. Every bit counts. We're also stealing from... Why do they turn into, like, magic? What is this nonsense? We're also stealing from this flower shop. But I don't care. Long hair, no care. Short care, don't air. Back air. Forward air, neutral air. B. Special. I don't know. All right. There's some items back here. And I remember I can sneak around in the grass. To avoid battles. I won't always avoid battles, which is all right. But, we will get a decent... We will get a lot less battles, I should say. Alright, there's one more over there. Though I'm wondering whether or not this is faster than just having the battles. Alright, there we go. X-Attack. Got it. Got the X-Attack, my man. Alright, let's head this way. Anything around here? Nothing. I think there's gonna be something here. Nope. Alright. So I'm gonna have to sneak out of this grass. Or I can just get a battle. That would be nice. Alright. Taylor! Alright, so we're gonna have to run from this thing, of course. Because, like I already said, we don't have another capture, which is a good thing. It's a good thing that map is very detailed, because otherwise I would be capturing Pokemon that I shouldn't left and right. Alright, get out! There we go. There are a couple battles over here that I think I'm gonna be able to avoid. And we can get our way straight to Rustboro. Dang it! It was so close. Must have been waiting for me to be like, alright, we'll battle. We'll battle. Why not, man? Why not? Oh, you're a girl. Lady Cindy. Alright, so send out Zigzagoon. She also has a full restore, remember. I do remember, so hopefully we can take this out in one shot. Because that would be cool. Otherwise, I would be sad. Alright, so Clauncher has so far been obeying us. I don't know if once it hits level 10 it's going to stop, but that's going to be a pain if it does. Alright, that was decent. That was decent damage. Let's go with Flail to get it past the little halfway mark, and then we'll do Crab Hammer again to seal the deal. And this should avoid us, or this should keep us from having to deal with her healing, which is even more annoying than having to do this, I should say. I should say so, sir. Alright, well, critical hit, and we have less HP. Alright, hopefully you don't heal. Thank you, you're just gonna use Growl, which is okay, because we'll kill you anyway. So, use Crab Hammer. What?! Wow! Alright, you're gonna heal, so let's go ahead and use a Swords Dance. Man, that's annoying! Swords Dance, I think, does +2 in the attack stat, and we've only lost 1 to Growl, so I think we should... do more damage this time around, unless it uses Growl again, which I knew it would. Oh, this can be so irritating. I think we actually might be -1. Regardless, let's keep this up. We're pretty close. I guess we're just forced to do one more. Alright, I'm kind of worried that you're gonna kill us next time you do an attack, so unless we get a crit here. Well, thank you! Oh, it wasn't a crit. I guess it was just the max damage that we were able to take. Alright. Zigzag screwed a level 6. And Route screwed a level 4. And Learn Confusion. I think level 5 will come up. Yep. What about 6? Nope. Didn't get the 3 levels, but that's alright. Alright. Well, so finally we can head forward. You're a trainer, but I'm glad I avoided you. Alright, so please tell me this is not a forced battle. It used to be... In the original games, it used to be an optional battle because you didn't have to do it. But this time around, it is going to be forced. We're twins, so we battled Pokemon together too. All right, you're gonna battle our Pokemon. Don't tell me what to do. You are not my mother. You do not have the right to tell me what to do. All right. After this fight, we are going to be able to get to where is it at? Where are we going? We're going to Rustboro City. And we were able to heal up for the first time and all that jazz. What should I do? Bum ba da da dum. Let's go for that. And then I know it's not going to do much, but it's better than nothing. Because we're kind of at a standstill in terms of type. So. Probably would have been better to do Crab Hammer there. That did actually a decent amount of damage. Alright, you're using Harden. That's going to be annoying to get around. And Astonish. Too bad you can't make us flinch because we're faster. Alright, let's do a Seedot again. And pound on Lotad again. Dang, we slapped the crap out you, man. Alright, so Bubble Beam for some reason did... Oh, because he's raising his defense. But Bubble Beam's defensive. It's special, so it's not going to do that much. Alright. Oh, crap. That didn't do that much, though. But now I know that he's got that, so I need to keep that in mind. Alright, let's go Bubble Beam on Seedot. And... You know what? Let's go... Let's go Crab Hammer on Lotad and Pound on Lotad as well. Let's just get this done. Let's take out Lotad once and for all. Oh, critical hit, nice. And then Crab Hammer will take out Lotad. And Seedot is just going to keep hardening, I think. So we should be okay here. Level 10, not bad. Not even bad. Oh, and everybody's leveling up, that's right. Gotta get used to this. Are we gonna evolve? I don't remember what level we evolve at. It's exactly level 7, or sand attack. Still no attacking moves, so we're gonna have to keep it growing. Or not growing, yeah, actually growing. Experience sharing in the party in the background, or just put it in the box. Either way, we will be doing the same thing, not worrying about it. Let's pound this as well. This should be it for Seedot, and this should be it for, wow. That did nothing. Hopefully Bubble Beam doesn't like make it live barely. There we go. Cool. Now I love you, Seedot. I love you so much, but you're dead and I'm sorry. Alright, let's see who else is gonna level up. Routes go to level 6, not bad. And learn double team, that is pretty good. Alright, I'm so disappointed that we lost. We lost even though we fought together. Yeah, but that's not always the case, or not always the best life. Alright, so there we go. That is it. I think there's something over here we can do. What do you give us? This old lady gives us something. You see bears going, blah, blah, blah. It gives us a chesto berry, okay. And there are plenty of berries there. But we don't need those right now. So, wait, let's go this way. That is going to be it for this episode of Pokemon OmegaRuby Wonderlocke, and we got an X defense, not bad. So, we are here in Rustboro, and we'll be able to explore Rustboro later on. But that is going to be it for this episode. Like I said, if you guys enjoyed it, please do drop a like on this video. And I will see you all in the next one. Have a fantastic day.